Welcome to this Vray feature short demonstration. In this video, we will take a look at the Vray displacement modifier together with the Vray hair material and the Ornatrix plugin, all supported in Vray GPU. The concept of displacing a mesh is taking a polygon mesh object, subdividing it into smaller polygons and offsetting them along the normals. The amount of offset depends on the values of a texture and the displacement amount parameter. This way, white values in the map will offset 5 cm, black values are not going to be offset at all, and grayscale values will be offset within that range. If an 8 bits per channel texture is used for displacement, its values are positive and one cannot have both positive and negative offset. That's why the displacement shift can be set to half the amount in negative direction. It is important to note that both the shift and amount parameters are in world units. In the case when floating point maps are used for displacement, the amount value should be set to 1 and no shift is required. This is because these maps can contain negative and larger than 1 values that do not need adjustments. A unique feature of the Vray displacement is the water level. It allows you to remove the geometry below a certain displacement amount. The value of water level is measured in world units and should be larger than the shift value. The removed polygons are not stored in memory and not processed at all, making the feature very optimized. Displacement can also be performed in a different direction than the polygon's normals. This way, more complex shapes can be achieved. This can be done using the vector displacement mode. It requires special RGB maps that can be extracted from external tools or using the Vray vector displacement bake material. The level of detail for a displacement can be controlled by the edge length parameter. It tells Vray how long an edge is allowed to be. If any edge is longer than that value, it is subdivided, thus refining the displaced mesh. The length of an edge can be measured in world space, in our case centimeters, and also in screen space, in pixels. That is set by the view-dependent option. If it is disabled, the edge length is calculated in world units. Otherwise, it is the number of pixels an edge occupies in the rendering. This is a great optimization since edges far from the camera are not subdivided that much and do not take up memory. That's why it is enabled by default and it is not recommended to turn it off. Let's open up the render settings and make sure that active shade is set to Vray RT. For NVIDIA GPUs, it is recommended to render with the CUDA engine type, so let's choose that and click the render button. Overall, our model has just a basic shape and no details. We can use displacement to add all the needed detail. Let's start with the helmet and add the displacement modifier. If we take a look at the displacement texture, we'll see that the midpoint is 0.5 and overall we have values from 0 to 1. That means that the texture minimum and maximum could be set from 0 to 1 to cover the range of the texture values. Since the midpoint is 0.5, we need to shift back the displacement with that value. To make the displacement stronger, we can double the amount. We need to compensate for that in the shift value as well. Let's apply a metal material to the helmet. Using the same approach, we can add displacement to the armor as well. The displacement texture used on the armor, though, has values less than 0 and greater than 1. To cover the whole range, we should set the texture minimum and maximum to appropriate values. Let's take a closer look at the sleeve and utilize the water level feature. Just as before, we can start off by adding a displacement modifier, reset all of its settings, and plug in a texture. We can lower the displacement amount if the effect is too strong. By ticking on the water level checkbox, we can clip all the geometry that is below a specified height, in this case 0.1 cm. A larger edge length value could cause some jagged edges, so let's lower it. Let's apply a meto material to the chainmail as well. The helmet has some hair on it, which is currently hidden. Let's unhide it and apply a V-Ray hair material on it. The V-Ray hair material is optimized for rendering hair and fur objects. The hair and fur objects have additional information that can be extracted with the V-Ray hair info text texture. For example, we can extract the position from root to tip for every hair and map colors along it. It can also be used with black and white colors to drive the transparency of the hairs. This makes the tips looking soft and fuzzy. Another mode of the V-Ray hair info text is random by strand index, which gives a random color based on the index of each strand. This can be used to introduce variation in the hair. To quickly achieve a certain type of hair look, we can choose one of the presets in the V-Ray hair material. Since hairs are thin and translucent, their main color should be set by the transmission color. Let's change it. We can use the V-Ray hair info texture to bring in some variation. For example, we can use position along strand to assign different colors to the root and the tip of each hair strand. We can also use the bias setting to favor either the first or the second color. If we choose the random by strand index output, each hair strand would be colored in either the first or the second color. Again, using the bias, we can control this further. By using pure black and white colors in the V-Ray hair info texture, we can use it in the opacity slot of our material to drive the softness of each hair strand tip. Let's assign a red hair material and increase the hair count significantly to achieve a better look. Let's unhide the animal fur, which was created in the exact same way, and let it render. In this video, we went through simple steps explaining how displacement works and how we can utilize it on the GPU. We have also covered the hair material and the hair info texture. I hope you have found this video useful and helpful. Please give us your feedback, comment or share it. If you'd like to follow along this tutorial, you can download the scene from the link provided in the description of this video. Make sure you check out more of the V-Ray feature videos and be on the lookout for new ones. Thank you for watching.